described and captioned media program. In the classroom and on the go. DCMP.org.
AMBROSE Video Publishing Incorporated presents Great Authors of the British Isles, Early Novelists.
One of the most remarkable stories of British literature is the rise of a man from humble beginnings to become the author of the most influential text ever written in English. An uneducated man born in 1628 in the English countryside, a man who was the son of a common tinker. That man was John Bunyan. Throughout his early years, Bunyan struggled with morality, Christianity, and the meaning of life. Like many Christian mystics, he had an epiphany. He came to understand that man's nature was essentially flawed, and no worldly acts would lead to salvation. Only continued faith in God's grace held the key to salvation. At various times, he was imprisoned for his religious beliefs. Beliefs that were at the heart of Bunyan's great Christian allegory, Pilgrim's Progress, a work written in two parts that many call the first English novel. It begins when the narrator, Bunyan, defends the story he's about to tell, the story which is framed as a dream. He explains that he fell asleep in the wilderness and dreamed of a man named Christian, who was tormented by spiritual anguish. A spiritual guide named Evangelist visits Christian and urges him to leave the city of destruction. In Bunyan's free prose, he writes,
"Then said Evangelist, why not willing to die, since this life is attended with so many evils? The man answered, because I fear that this burden that is upon my back will sink me lower than the grave."
The evangelist then claims that salvation can only be found in the celestial city known as Mount Zion. And so begins the pilgrim's allegorical journey to salvation. Today, those who share Bunyan's Christian faith continue to revere his writings as a spiritual guide. And students of English literature regard his spiritual autobiography as something new, something novel, and thus the first English novelist. Bunyan died in 1688, one of England's most beloved writers and preachers.
The described and captioned media program provides services designed to benefit students who are blind, visually impaired, deaf, hard of hearing, and deafblind. These services include a library of free loan described and captioned educational media, a clearinghouse of information related to educational media access, a gateway to internet resources related to accessibility, and a set of guidelines for adding descriptions and captions to media. There are no user registration or service fees. Visit the DCMP at dcmp.org. The DCMP is funded by the U.S. Department of Education and administered by the National Association of the Deaf.